If I told you that Serena Williams had 80% of first serve during a set, and I asked you to guess the score of that set, what would you say? 6-4? 6-2? 6-love? Maybe you could think her opponent had a very good first serve percentage as well, and this set was decided in a tiebreak. Well, during the first set of the 2019 Wimbledon Final, Serena Williams had 80% of first serves, and still Simona Halep broke her serve twice and won that set 6-2. How did she do that? How can someone get two breaks of serves against one of the best servers on the tour when you're having such amazing numbers? This is one of the many questions we will try to answer in this video. My name is Jorge, and today I'll try to analyze the tactics that Simona Halep used to win this Wimbledon final. As I have told you in other videos, these type of researchers have two parts. The first part is data. This is me gathering the numbers and statistics by watching the entire match while I take notes about what happened, and by looking at official sources of data like the Wimbledon website. The second part is my interpretation of the data I gather. This is what I try to understand and give meaning to the numbers. I'm telling you this because the numbers I will present you are a fact. They are real. However, what is debatable is my interpretation of the numbers. This means you could see the numbers and have a completely different opinion, and that's okay. If that's the case, please write it down in the comment section. Having said that, let's get started. After evaluating this match, I concluded that what made Halep win this final was the combination of three factors: Williams' unforced errors, Halep's rally distribution, and Halep's return of serve. Let's start with Serena's unforced errors, since it's one of the aspects many commentators and analysts talked about. In this match, Serena had a total of 26 unforced errors, and as you can imagine, having that number in a two-set match can give you a lot of trouble. To give you a better look at what this number means, I want you to take a look at the following table. In this table, I'm showing you Serena's performance during the entire tournament in terms of games played and the amount of unforced errors. Basically, I gathered the amount of unforced errors and counted the games played at every match. Then I did a simple math. I divided the amount of unforced errors by the number of games. This division allowed me to get the ratio of unforced errors by game. In other words, it allowed me to see the average unforced errors by game. Ideally, you want this number to be as low as possible, and as you can see, Serena did a good job in many of the matches she played. You can see numbers of 0.66, 0.62, 0.79, and so on. However, when you look at the number she had during the final against Halep, you can see that it is 1.63. This was the biggest number she had during the entire tournament, and she had it against one of the most consistent players in the world, a player that only made 3 unforced errors during the entire match. However, the story doesn't end there. I decided to take a closer look at this final, in particular at the games where Halep broke Williams' serve. In this match, Simona broke serve 4 times, and in those 4 games alone, Williams had 10 unforced errors. That means that in the most important moments of the match, the ratio we just talked about raised from 1.63 to 2.5, making her even more vulnerable. Now, let's talk about the second aspect, and that is Halep's distribution during rallies. In this match, one thing that was clear is that Halep didn't want Williams to hit the ball comfortably. She made an effort to constantly change directions. During many points, she made Serena run left to right and right to left. The more she forced Serena to run, the less chances she gave her to take control of the points. To confirm this suspicion, I decided once again to compare numbers. This time, what I did is that I took notice of something called distance covered by points. This stat, as its name suggests, tells us the average distance run in a point during the entire match. And as you can see, The match where we have the biggest number was this final with 11.2 meters. We can see how there are other matches that come close to this final, like the semi-final or the fourth round. But the player that made Serena run the most in average was Simona Halep. Finally, let's discuss the last aspect and the one I found the most interesting to talk about, Halep's return of serve. In particular, what she did to return Serena's first serve. You see, what surprised me the most about Simona's return is that she was able to predict where Serena was going to serve and cover that place before Serena hit the ball. How did Simona do this? First, she went to her normal return position. Second, she waited until Serena tossed the ball in the air. And finally, once Serena's eyes were staring at the ball and not the opponent, she moved to cover the place she believed Serena was going to target. By performing this tactic during the match, Simona improved the chances of hitting good returns, and in consequence, she raised the odds of winning more points with her opponent's serve. I can't tell you how she performed this tactic during the match, because it's something you can notice as a spectator. Unfortunately, what I cannot tell you is how she predicted where Serena was going to serve. I tried to look at the stats of previous matches during this tournament to see if I could catch any serving patterns about Serena. However, the stats I could get are only set by set, and they show an even distribution between the white serve and the T serve on both the deuce side and the ad side. I also tried to see if I could catch any difference in the service motion, but I couldn't see anything in particular. So, if you have any idea or theory about how she did this, please let me know in the comment section. What we can discuss is how effective this tactic was. If my numbers are correct, this match had 47 points played with Serena's serve. Out of these 47 points, Halep tried to use this tactic on 30 points. And out of these 30 points, she guessed right on 20 points. In my opinion, performing this tactic gave her two very important benefits. The first benefit is the one we just talked about. By guessing right, Simona got the opportunity of hitting better returns. Returns that had depth. Returns that didn't allow Serena to take control of the point from the start. The second benefit is that I believe that by performing this tactic, she put a lot more pressure on Serena's serve. Here's my theory about this. By looking at the numbers, I could see that the serve she was able to predict the most was the T serve on the ad side. In total, she predicted this serve 15 times, and she was right on 14. During the first set, Serena tried to hit this serve 7 times, and she got the first serve in 5 times out of those 7. From those 5 serves she got in, Halep only missed the return twice. The other 3 times, Halep made Serena work hard during rallies. Because Halep starts performing this tactic after Serena is looking at the ball, it's very hard for Serena to see Halep moving, and therefore it's very hard for her to realize what Halep is doing. What I believe happened is that she didn't realize in time this was happening, and instead of changing the distribution, instead of hitting the wide serve more often, she tried to force her serve. If you take a look at the first serve distribution on the ad side between the first set and the second set, there isn't a big difference. During the second set, she kept hitting these serves on the ad side. During this set, she tried to hit this serve 8 times, but only got this serve in 4 times. In other words, her first serve percentage dropped. She had to play more with her second serve, and since she was making many unforced errors, she eventually lost her serve twice. In general, these are the aspects that I believe allow her to win this match. Now, it's your turn to let me know what you think. Do you agree with this analysis? Do you have a different opinion? Please let me know in the comment section. Also, I wanted to let you know that I created a Facebook group for those of you that want to talk about strategies, share your experiences during your matches, or ask for advice. If you want to join the group, I will leave a link on the video description below. And if you want to see more videos like this in the future, subscribe to this channel and click the bell icon. Once again, my name is Jorge, thanks for watching, and I will see you on the next one.